Hello friends, my name is Shreyas. Welcome back in another video. In the previous video, we solved static assignment 1. If you didn't watch that video, then link is available in the description. In this video, we will solve static assignment 2. So make sure you have clicked that subscribe button. So in problem statement is a dance club is conducting auditions to admit interested candidates. You need to implement a participant class for the dance club based on the class diagram and description given below. And in main method, here they given a parameterized constructor, and parameters are string name, long contact number, string city. Initialize the name, contact number and city instance variables appropriately with the values passed to the constructor. Generate the registration ID using static variable counter, and the value of registration ID should start from D10001, and the numerical part should be incremented by 1 for the subsequent values. Initialize the counter in static block. Implement the appropriate getter and setter methods. Test the functionalities using the provided tester class. Create two or more participant objects and validate that the values of the member variables are proper. And below, sample input and output are given. So first of all, we will copy this whole code from here and open Eclipse IDE. Then create new project and give it a name as static assignment 2. Then create a class in it and give it a name tester and paste this code here. Here in class participant, you can see a comment implement your code here. So we will start typing code from here. As we seen in class diagram, we will create variables and methods here now. Private static int counter, private static registration ID, private string name, private long contact number. Private string city. Now initialize the counter in static block. Now create a parameterized constructor and initialize the name, contact number and city instance variables. In this method, we will generate the registration ID. Using the static variable counter. And it's done. After running program, you can see we got output we wanted. In the next video, we will solve static assignment 3. So if you have any query or getting error while running code, then you can comment in comment section. So thanks for watching till now. Press like if it helped you and share this video with your friends and subscribe this channel to get notified for next video.